A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with Elizabeth about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord. My soul proclaims. We can all write our own Magnificat. It would be interesting to read how in various ways God intervenes in the lives of each one of us. To magnify God or to proclaim God's greatness seems easy. Sadly, as we go through life achieving great things, reaping successes, and becoming great in the eyes of people, we end up magnifying ourselves instead of God. The Apostle Paul reminds us that if ever we must boast only of those things that show our weakness and therefore proclaim God's power and greatness. It is not easy to do. Who would want to boast of sufferings, hardships, persecutions, and humiliations? Perhaps only a fool, we would say, if you are to write a Magnificat of your own, how will it sound like?